presented by Seat77.com. As always, Dave DeBye is coming to you live from the Super Plus Seat 77 broadcast studio in the heart of Silicon Valley. Now, Dave DeBye.
North America, welcome, welcome, welcome to the Dave DeBye Big Show. And now, for a quick rundown of the world of sports. Today, we begin with the bearded one, Ryan Fitzpatrick, the only quarterback in the National Football League who looks like he just walked off the set of Game of Thrones. Ryan, who has been embroiled in a highly publicized standoff with the New York Jets, finally signed a one-year deal worth $12 million. The dispute between the two sides revolved around Ryan wanting a long-term deal, which, of course, the Jets weren't going to give him. So Ryan updated his resume, stopped shaving his beard, and went hunting for a new deal. Because when you're looking for a job, nothing says hire me like an out-of-control beard that looks like a squirrel is going to leap out to safety. So I started to wonder, what would Ryan's resume look like? I bet his headline said something like this. Experienced QB, team leader, able to get along nicely with obnoxious wide receivers like Brandon Marshall. And threw for nearly 4,000 yards and set a team record with 31 TDs in the most pressure-packed market in North America. Oh, and my teammates call me Fitzmagic. Watch me pull a rabbit out of my beard, yells Fitzpatrick. Come on, Ryan, at least trim that down a little so you can see blitzing linebackers. Seriously, his beard is so out of control that I think he can only see like 40% of the field. Fitzpatrick, who is the very definition of a journeyman QB, has already made stops during his career at the bottom of the NFL with teams like the Rams, Bengals, Titans, Texans, and he spent four long years trying to get the damn Buffalo Bills to actually circle the wagon. Ryan, who has a career quarterback rating of just over 80 and has delivered 152 TDs versus 116 interceptions during his career. So not bad, but not great, which is why his new $12 million deal makes him the 21st highest paid QB in the league. Now look, if you subtract the teams he had already played for and the teams who needed a starting quarterback, you end up with a list of less than a handful of options. So Ryan found himself in kind of an online dating bind. Okay, so stay with me for a second as I attempt to weave online dating into a National Football League free agency story. You know, you've been using the same online dating site for a while, and you end up getting matched up with the same people you've already gone out with. And most of the other options, quite frankly, just don't look so good. The only real option Ryan had was the Denver Broncos. The Broncos, who had just lost Mr. I Didn't Use HGH Peyton Manning to retirement and was left at the altar by a runaway QB named Brock Osweiler, quickly scrambled to update their Denver Bronco online dating profile. The Broncos online dating profile read, "Just won the Super Bowl, one of the best defenses in the league, looking for a game manager QB who wants to live in a state where weed is legal and the Sports Authority has just gone out of business. Come on, Sports Authority! Your stores work great, and now my only sporting good option is Big Five, who famously carries all the latest gear from 5 years ago. Seriously, the only store in America when you buy basketball shoes, the glue shows up on the outside of the shoes. Big Five is a sporting goods store equivalent to the grocery outlet, which encourages its customers to not check its expiration dates. Hey, honey, check out this cheddar cheese. It's only 99 cents, for which my wife might reply, it's not supposed to be green." So the Broncos and Fitzpatrick started exchanging messages and pokes, which quickly turned into flirting. But after several months, both sides started playing hardball, and the Broncos simply decided to date Mark Sanchez exclusively. Fast forward to Lake Tahoe, where Ryan played in the American Century Celebrity Golf Championships over the weekend. Ryan finished in 51st place. Look, any thoughts about a professional golf career immediately got thrown out the door when he only beat Charles Barkley by like 30 spots. So when his weekend of bad golf finished up, Ryan was still teamless, and his only real option was to return to the New York Football Jets. The Jets, who spent the entire offseason trying to convince themselves that Geno Smith isn't that bad. Geno Smith is kind of like going on a date with someone a few times. Sure, there's no attraction and certainly no spark. You've even noticed that he has anger management issues, like the time he yelled at the poor waiter for putting ice in his water. But sometimes you get what you get. Well, the Jets finally came to their senses and must have admitted internally that Geno was indeed a bad dating option, and quickly added a few dollars to a one-year offer, and presto! They secured the services of a journeyman QB who really isn't that bad. I, at this point, would like to personally take a minute and thank both the Jets and Ryan Fitzpatrick for wasting everyone's time with all your silliness. This is a deal that should have been done right away, and making everyone suffer because of both parties' stupidity is unacceptable. Hey, Ryan, next time around, maybe you should post your resume on LinkedIn or on the Career Builder Network. And for the love of God, man, trim that beard. Okay, North America, thanks for all of your support. We are available on Facebook, Twitter, The Sound of Cloud, Spreaker. Big news last week, we are now on iHeartRadio. You can check us out in the podcast section there. And of course, our big iTunes channel is blowing up. All right, North America, I am Dave DeBaugh, reminding you that not everyone can be a champion, Ron Rivera, but everyone, and I do mean everyone, can act like one, Cam. And good luck, North America.